Good morning, 47. We have a lead on the Shadow Client. ICA White Hats have traced the anonymous data received by our clients to one Olivia Hall, brilliant young hacktivist and suspect in a dozen cases of cyber vandalism. Using onion routing with state-of-the-art encryption, Hall went to a lot of trouble to stay untraceable. She is good, but we are better. Her digital trail has led us to a remote farm in Colorado, where satellite footage has revealed what appears to be the training camp for a private militia, led by an already registered target, Sean Rose, Australian environmental terrorist and explosives expert wanted for a series of public bombings. Rose was spotted near the scene of Thomas Cross's kidnapping, which makes him our prime suspect for the Shadow Client. Spurred by Eric Soders, the ICA Board of Directors has asked us to infiltrate the farm and eliminate Sean Rose, along with three other prominent militia members. Ezra Berg, retired Mossad interrogator. Penelope Graves, former Interpol anti-terror analyst. And finally, Maya Parvati, former assassin and gunrunner for the Tamil Tigers. I'll be honest with you, 47. I consider Eric Soder's reasoning hasty and ill-advised. Now, we cannot go against the wishes of the board, but we can conduct our own investigation. Whether a direct threat to the ICA or not, we need to know the Shadow Client's true agenda. I will leave you to prepare. Welcome to Colorado, 47. The militia has taken up HQ at an old apricot farm and appear to be training for a series of coordinated strikes, ranging from cyber attacks to full-blown guerrilla warfare. The Shadow Client appears to unite specialists and radicals from all over the map. Mercenaries and terrorists, hackers and spies joined by an unknown common cause. Satellite scans indicate that the command room is below ground inside an old tornado shelter. Only Rose appears to have access, however, so to get inside, you will need to get creative. This environment is hostile and highly alert, so tread carefully. Good luck, 47.
Yeah, let's see.
Find out what that was.
Affirmative.
That is Sean Rose, terrorist turned insurgent.
Okay, everyone step back. Fire in the hole.
Charge is too weak. Mix another batch of gel. This time, add another 5% of nitroglycerin.
Sure thing, Sean.
I need the mixture to be precise. The contents of the safe cannot be damaged. When you're done, text me, and I'll come by and check you haven't created something that will blow us all to kingdom come. That is all.
That's never gonna be powerful enough. Guess it might try.
Yes, it is. I'm glad you asked.
We have
versus the ever evil Spec Ops.
That is Penelope Graves, acclaimed anti-terror analyst. Strange to see her as part of this crowd. This sounds promising. The militia received a large shipment of nitroglycerin this morning, which is now stored at the munitions depot. Apparently, Rose himself plans to apply and test the gel as soon as a sample is ready.
Possible intruder. Sweeping area. Over.
Keep those eyes peeled, bro.
Good. Standing down.
Thank you.
Well done, 47. When Rose comes back, he's in for an explosive surprise.
Okay, everyone step back. Fire in the hole.
That was an explosion. Scott, you're on point.
Sean Rose confirmed down. Nicely done, 47.
Courtyard seems to be clear. Moving on. Over.
So what's this I hear about a training accident?
That would be Bert.
Security is so tight, my friend. I can't even let my own guys in.
Operation.
I know, it sucks.
Clipped by a ram or something?
The team trains with a battering ram to simulate the attack on Secretary Torres' motorcade. I don't know. I guess
a battering ram has injured one of the strike team, point man by the name of Burgess. And according to those militiamen, Maya Parvati oversees training. Sounds promising. I suggest you infiltrate the strike team, 47. Perhaps you can relieve the hapless point man of his duties.
So you got your ex-military, the mercenary.
I saw a couple of cicada guys arrive.
Don't you dare mess up this fucking day!
No!
Thank you.
scare anybody.
Let's not go full weight, though, Max.
Let's put you on the next cut.
This is regular. Security will be a more important.
Oh. Command, possible.
That is Maya Parvati, Sri Lankan assassin turned pirate turned insurgent.
If we don't get this shipped across the border soon, the whole tourist mission is at risk.
Got it, ma'am. I'll try to improve.
I'm back.
Well, well, our very own punching bag. Any broken bones?
Wounded pride. That's all.
Good to hear. All right, head over to the briefing area. We'll resume in a moment.
I expect you all to know this by heart. But in case amnesia has set in, here's the sequence. Advance to the car with haste. Eliminate the passengers. Retrieve the briefcase. Extract. Got that? And remember, speed and accuracy is the name of the game. All right. Now go pick up your weapons and get in position. Move out.
Parvati won't know what hit her. Maya Parvati
hey,
is down.
Buddy,
good work.
Put that weapon away.
It's a beautiful piece of work.
In school, they always talked a lot about the separation of powers. You know, in the Constitution.
What?
Hey, is anyone there? Come on, man.
What friggin' ever?
shows you who you really are. Either you press that trigger and stand up for yourself, or you don't, right?
Well, let's just go over the top. It's just a gun, right?
What I'm saying is that a weapon is like a mirror to your soul. When it's decided who you really are, when that moment arises, it'll arise precisely because you have a gun in your hand.
Yeah. Sure. That's really interesting. Let's talk about someone else before you raid Capitol Hill, okay? Later, dude.
I've spent all the significant moments in my life with this weapon. I sometimes feel like he's my best friend in the world. My companion.
I'm losing you, man.
No, it's not. It's what stands between you and your loved ones and all the evilness in the world. No lawyer or politician will be coming to help you when shit hits the fan. But this gun, it will. This gun is the power to control how things will go down. Get it?
Okay. Maybe you should see a head doctor, amigo. Because that shit makes no sense. See you around.
Graves is down. Excellent work, 47.
Focus with all these questions.
Not a problem. I'll just look at it. It's really something else watching you work. I've always wanted to get into interrogation.
Is that so?
Absolutely. Nothing violent. If you do love.
What the? What?
Thank you.
you got the mandatory spot assignment.
Power failure.
No.
No.
Hey, but no trespassing. Violators will be shot, and survivors will be shot again.
You just saved yourself a lot of trouble.
Sir, you dropped something.
That is Ezra Berg, former Mossad interrogator. His services are in demand at the moment. That's all targets taken care of, 47. Now gain access to the tornado shelter.
Fighting for the free world.
Hey, check up on the nitroglycerin. We need to make sure we got more than enough.
Wait a second. Yeah, we're ready for World War III.
Good. That reminds me, I need to check with Rose if we need anything.
In space.
Special for my friend.
Free dimensions.
I know what it does. I just have a hard time grasping it. Could we print out our own weapons?
Sure. Maybe a small gun for something really specific. It's beautiful tech for assassins. But old school weapons are still cheaper and more reliable.
So I hear Rose had his own face scan for 3D masking after he saw Berg's mask. One of the hackers keeps the facial data on his laptop.
Sorry, but do I know you? Hey, excuse me, I'm talking to you.
Hey, soldier, what the hell do you think you're doing?
Oh, yeah, no, wait, no, my shift's over. I want to bug someone else. I'm watching TV and stuff. You get anything?
Don't give me lip, rookie! I'll have you straddled on a post before you know it! Now, if I come back here and see you still here, there will be hell to pay. Got that, soldier? Oh, it's a goddamn joke.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so Rose is building an explosive battery unit for a new force.
But Rose wants to control the time of detonation, so I designed this software trigger. Works by email. Devereaux checks it, the virus infects the watch, triggers the charge, and boom.
Well, that is hardcore.
Man, these people don't piss about.
Yeah, well, still beats working at a bank.
Salute, soldier.
Excuse me. Beg your pardon, sir.
Thank you.
47. It appears the door to the tornado shelter is protected by a biometric lock. To gain access, you need Sean Rose's body, or something equally convincing.
I got tons of respect for you guys.
Quite
Identify yourself.
Give me lip, rookie! I'll have you... Come back here and see you still here. There will be hell to pay. Got that, soldier? Oh, this
is good. Yeah, whatever.
Okay, so you know how Rose keeps his desk tidy, like...
Whoa, what a shock!
What the...
Hello?
Hey,
it's just me,
don't
throw anything at me, please.
Okay, so you know how Rose keeps his desk tidy like a Japanese garden, right?
Thickens.
Someone left in a hurry.
Sean Rose was not the Shadow Client. That much is clear. Whoever commands the militia, they got out just in time. Look around, 47. We're getting closer.
Some kind of network. Power plants. From all sectors.
Familiar faces, too. Thomas Cross. Klaus Strandberg. Ether. And that's missing banker Eugene Cobb. Well, well.
There's a name. Providence.
What? No. No, it can't be.
The Hidden Hand. Thought they were a myth.
A hypothesis, nothing more. The idea that a small cabal of kingmakers, controlling enough corporate and political leaders, could effectively run the world in secret.
Maybe not so hypothetical.
Keep looking, 47. We need full disclosure.
Found something.
Sodas. But that would mean... Providence. Has infiltrated ICA. And Eric Soders is their operative. Bastard! It all fits. He was the one who persuaded the rest of the ICA board to greenlight this operation. This changes everything. Get out, 47. We got what we came for.
What about the Shadow Client?
He is no longer our primary concern. ICA has been compromised. I always wondered if Providence was real, but I never actually... I will need to confer with the board, but mark my words, 47. This will have consequences.
Rose is gone.
It was me, wasn't it? They tracked me. I don't believe it. I took every precaution.
Rose knew the risks. They all do. You did well, Olivia. I am proud of you. Now listen. The ICA knows about you. They kept you alive because they needed you, and now they don't. We won't talk again. Not until the storm is over.
I don't like it. This man you know what he's capable of. You need to end this now.
I ran away as a boy. My friend and I. Away from that place. We came upon a small farming community. The people were dirt poor, but this woman, she took us in. We were awakened the next morning by the shots. A dozen people lay face down in the snow. A warden didn't like to leave witnesses. They shot the woman and her family last. They made sure that we watched the whole thing. This is your gift, the warden told us. Your gift and your curse. Touching lives. Only by ending them.
You know him.
Better than anyone.